VA home loan IED. Minimum property requirements as it pertains to the VA home loan. This answers a lot of questions, so you're going to want to stand by to get some. My name is Brad Stinson, the Mortgage Marine. Every day, I am inundated with questions. Well, the VA won't allow this, and the VA does this. Is this going to go VA? Is this going to be a problem? Well, some are true, some aren't. So let's take a look at this. Ready to get in the foxhole? Let's do this. First, I want to start off by saying, and this is, you know, pretty common through every single video that I record. Who you work with truly does matter. Boo-hoo. Who would have thought? A VA experienced realtor, when they're walking through the home, they're going to be able to point out these things that may cause an issue. And it becomes a negotiating point or a talking point when you are submitting an offer. So a couple things to consider here before we get down and dirty with this. Number one, condos. If you're going to look at a condo, it's very important that you either touch base with the realtor or the lender to make sure that the condo association is on the VA approved list. Because believe it or not, there is a list on the VA's website that has approved associations. Now, if the condo is not on the approved list, that's not a deal breaker. It's easy to submit the package as long as you know what you're doing. Now, back in May of 2018, the VA released an announcement that here in the state of Michigan, in the state of Michigan alone, site condos no longer need to be approved through the VA. That is huge here in the state of Michigan because site condos are all over the place. The second thing to consider is unique properties. Okay, unique properties are going to be a red flag. Unique properties, I'm talking about A-frame homes and every veteran's dream. I want to live in a log cabin out in the middle of nowhere, nobody around me. Well, these are going to cause issues because an appraiser uses recent comparable sale homes, or as real estate agents and lenders like to refer to them as comps, to establish the value of your property. So log cabins, A-frame homes, properties with lots of acreage, and one of the more, this is like the common trend, like the great, like the rage right now is barn dominium homes or pole barn houses. We're gonna have trouble finding recent comparable sale homes to establish reasonable value for the property. So be wary of that. I'm gonna briefly sum up what the VA requires for your minimum property, like the basic bare minimum in which the property must meet. Keep in mind, the VA wants to put a veteran into a home that they can immediately occupy. And the VA protects veterans from themselves. We are our own worst enemy. Money makes us do stupid things, everybody across the board. Okay, so the VA helps protect veterans this way. The first thing to consider, it must be a residential property. Okay, now this is not saying if you work from home, you cannot do that. 25% or less of the dwelling can be considered a business. However, the home must be a residential property. Number two, must have adequate space for living, cooking, sleeping, and sanitary facility. Number three, the mechanical systems must be safe, reasonable future utility. Thanks for the clarification on the reasonable future utility. There's quite a few of these that are gonna have that same phrase, reasonable future utility. This means that if you move into the home, it's not gonna immediately break. All right, number four, heating. Must have adequate heating. Now this is gas, electric. Now, I have run into this numerous times. Primary source of heat is a wood burning stove. That's great. However, with the VA, you need to have a backup conventional system that kicks in the event that you don't have any wood or whatever, okay? So the backup must be able to sustain the house at 50 degrees Fahrenheit. That's 50. Makes sense, because pipes freeze. Next one, must have adequate, safe drinking water and a hot water supply. Okay, nobody wants to take a shower in a cold. Safe drinking water. Now, if you are hooked up to public water, that is considered safe. Okay, however, there are a lot of homes that do have a well as a water source. If that's the case, the VA does require a well inspection and a water test. Okay, the water test must conform to local standards, which is usually typically set forth by the health department. Sewage, typically if you're hooked up to public sewage, you're good. However, if you have septic, there needs to be an inspection done because the VA wants to ensure that there's safe disposal of the sewage. Here's a common one. No wood destroying insects. Termites. No fungus growth. No dry rot. No mold. I mean, come on. Who's gonna buy a house that has all this stuff without it being addressed beforehand? This is to protect the buyer. Another one. Paint. This is always a big one. Well, what if the VA requires everything to be painted? Well, yeah, I mean, the exterior of the home. The exterior of the home, do a quick walk around. If there's any cracked or peeling paint, that means your home is exposed to the elements. And here in the state of Michigan, we have four seasons in one day. So if your wood's exposed to the elements, it's gonna rot. Now we have an issue with, is your house structurally sound? Lead-based paint. If the home was built before 1978, lead-based paint must be evaluated and addressed and fixed. And lastly, structural. The VA is not going to allow a veteran to purchase a home that the foundation or the structure of the house is going to crumble. Come on. Who wants to buy a house that has a really bad foundation? All right, so that sums up briefly. This is brief. Minimum property requirements for the VA. Minimum property requirements when you're using your VA home loan benefit. The path to home ownership is laden with IEDs. It is my intent with these videos to help guide you and navigate you down this path, successfully avoiding these IEDs to achieve the overall mission of veteran home ownership. My name is Brad Stinson, the Mortgage Marine. If you like this video, please share, subscribe to my channel. Please give me feedback, comments below. Greatly appreciate it. I look forward to seeing you next week. Have a great week this week. Get after it. Semper Fi, and I'm out of here.